Welcome to Nemo Next Figure Channel. Today there was news from McFarlane Toys as they announced the new Batman DC Multiverse figure. Also, new figure comes from Tamashii Nation. Last new Godzilla figure from Hiya Toys. Before we start, let's hit the intro first. Again, McFarlane doesn't get tired of releasing Batman variants in their DC Multiverse line. Now, they released the Batman inspired from his first appearance from Detective Comics issue 27, with the high cowl ears, a small simple logo, and pink gloves. The interesting thing is that McFarlane decided to give this Batman a robe, made of fabric, with the help of wire inside, to make it easier when you pose it. Besides that, this Batman comes with 4 extra hands, a lot of accessories. There is a round base 10 and collection card as a default bonus. What I don't understand is why they give a range. For those who have read the comic, please tell me the reason. This version of Batman can be paired with the first appearance of Superman, which was previously released in collector edition format. Next, the Batman variant from Nightfall Black and Grey series. Batman Nightfall looks smaller than other Batman variants. You can see his shoulders are not wide. It has a grey basic color paired with a yellow Batman logo. Unlike Batman's first appearance, Batman Nightfall's robe is not made of fabric. It's most likely a rubber. The accessories are 2 extra hands and 1 batarang. Then there's a round base 10 and collection cards. Let's continue to Azazel. The suit was made detailed by adding textures in the gray parts, a long wings part almost touching the ground. What's unfortunate is, in the collection card pictures, you can see Azazel open his claws, but they don't give that as extra hands. The good thing is, the wing parts can be disassembled in total 6 pieces. All the Batmans will be released in May at $22.99 each. If you guys want to purchase those figures, I added the link in the description box. Next, we go to the SH Figurat Spider-Punk figure from the Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse movie. Judging from the color, this version will appear later in the second part of the movie. Just like the previous Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse SH figurines, this one also have a slim body with a very attention to details. On the back, we can see how they really attention to the small details on the leather jacket worn by Spider-Punk. They give us a guitar as accessories and extra hand to hold that guitar, complete with a guitar pick. There is an extra hand to hold the neck of the guitar when you want that guitar as a weapon. There are 8 extra hands so far. There's a lot to have in one figure. They are also give us a unmasked Spider-Punk head. The detail is insane. Next, Ahsoka from Star Wars Ahsoka series. Her facial design is nice, similar to the live action cast. Ahsoka comes with 2 iconic lightsabers and a robe made from cloth material, so you can display it in many poses. There's a large hoodie, it can cover almost her entire head. The robe can be removed if you don't want to use it. The details on the clothing are very nice. It's rarely Tamashii makes a mistake in creating figures from Star Wars series. The other accessories is a star map ball, and part of ball who have cut in half. Each of these SH figurines will be released in July. For pre-orders, open on March 4th. Lastly, after last week, Hiya Toys released the normal mode Godzilla variant from the latest movie Godzilla X Kong The New Empire. This time they released an evolved version by giving effects to the tail part. There is no striking difference, only the pink effect on the tail that look contrast. This Godzilla will be released in 4th quarter of 2024. The price is $51. I put the official purchase link in the description box. That's what's news for this episode. Like if this information is useful for you, subscribe, and discuss below in the comments section. I'll see you in another What's News episode. And goodbye.